I see most of the extension staff braced the inclement weather and being here with us this morning. But I'm happy that there are more extension than farmers, because your role is to encourage the farmers to do the best practices in the field. We'd have liked the farmers to have it firsthand, because we have an agronomist from St. Lucia, Mr. Manius Cherry, who is here with us, and he is going to give you all some of his practical experience in this area. In Grenada, most of the rural communities, as you know, the livelihood depended, that was pre-Hurricane Ivan, on the coconut industry. Subsequent to the two hurricanes, Ivan and Emily, we had a massive reduction in the number of coconut plants available to produce for the country. And as a result, Grenada started to import coconuts from neighboring St. Vincent. In addition to the hurricanes, we had a number of pests affected the coconut industry in Grenada as well. Okay? We know that many small enterprises are trying to revitalize their businesses, but the unavailability of coconuts is of major concern. Therefore, the availability of the nuts will create the opportunities for rural communities to improve their livelihoods. The coconut industry in the Caribbean, including Grenada, is vulnerable to the introduction of little yellowing disease. From my understanding, it is in Belize, it is in Jamaica. I'm not sure if there's any in the Windward Islands as yet, but it's just a matter of time. If we don't take the necessary precaution, it's likely we're going to have this disease here with us. Moreover, the prevalence of the aging trees, which have passed the optimum production range, warrants intervention to revitalize the industry by introducing good quality planting material that are high yielding and disease resistant. And this is what IICA, in collaboration with CC, which is the Yucatan Center for Scientific Research, and the Mexican government has collaborated to do. The Caribbean is not able to meet the growing global demand for coconut products, especially coconut water, a situation not likely to be resolved anytime soon. The urgency of the situation requires a strong, collaborative, and sustainable development program that is built on high-quality planting material, and IICA, in collaboration with the government of Mexico and CC, has provided. The coconut industry is targeted because of the growing opportunities in regional and global markets for a range of coconut products. The global market for coconut water alone is predicted to reach 4 billion US by 2019. It should be noted also that coconut water alone, that the demand for coconut products across the region is also increasing. The diverse market opportunities are important for you, the farmers and agro-processors, who would like to capitalize on those opportunities to get extra cash by producing value-added coconut products. Having realized such market potential, Grenada is now putting measures in place to facilitate improved coordination between stakeholders and guide the development of the national coconut sector. This begins with the introduction of disease-tolerant plants that are high-yielding and of good quality nuts and water. I'd like to say welcome again to you, and I'd like to thank you for your interest in participating in the revitalization of this crucial coconut industry.
It's wonderful to be here, and I just like to tell you that Mexico, me representing Mexico, we are very, very proud to be able to help Grenada in some of the agriculture issues at the moment. And we really are here and to channel any other agriculture help we can provide to you. As you know, the government of Mexico, together with the cooperation of the Center of Scientific Investigations of Yucatan in Mexico, the Embassy of the OECS in San Lucia for Mexico, the Inter-American Institute of Cooperation and Agriculture, IICA, and the Minister of Agriculture have made this project possible. These very special coconut plants, they were donated a few months ago here to Grenada, have been engineered by Mexican science at the Center of Scientific Investigations in Yucatan, are organic, are resistant to the yellow disease, and are tangible proof of a growing friendship and a strategic partnership between our two countries and IICA. It's wonderful to see that many of the plants have survived the trip from Mexico and they are growing healthy. And also to see that all of you are here today to receive the training and how to take a better care of them and try to make sure they survive. We know how important is the coconut industry for Grenada and how important it was before the hurricane. So hopefully with these plants here, we can rehabilitate that industry and also open new doors and opportunities to think about other ways that we can use coconut. As we know, the world is becoming more and more conscious of what we're eating, where our food is coming from, and what is the carbon footprint of our goods we're consuming. I think that the rehabilitation of the Grenada coconut industry can inspire Grenadians to develop new coconut-related products that are good and healthy to all. This is why it's very, very important we learn to grow them organically and ethically.
Coconut industry in Grenada has always been extremely important. And one time or other, we used to make soap from coconut. And coconut, I consider coconut as being intrinsically intertwined in our own culture and customs in Grenada. Coconut is used widely in our what are considered to be Grenada's famous oil dung. Without coconut, you can't have oil dung. Also, coconut is used widely in the craft industry. Coconut also is a very important medium in Grenada, and Grenada perspective in the growing of orchids in anthuriums. As you know, traditionally and even today, coconut is used, the fibers, as a good media for other crops. It could also be used in mattresses. It is also linked to the tourism industry. You could see many people getting lively. They see they make coconut hats and all kind of things. So, I mean, coconut is a very versatile, one of the most versatile agricultural products we have in Grenada. And don't talk about coconut is becoming a very important crop in terms of livelihoods. A lot of people sell coconut and they get their livelihoods. And again, the coconut water, very, very important. So from our perspective, coconut is hugely, hugely important. I must commend the initiative taken by IICA and through the support of the Mexican government. And only recently I had a big chat with a consultant who has been assigned to do a particular policy for Grenada in respect of the agriculture health and food safety. And I was indicating to him the conversation reached a point where I was highlighting to him how instrumental Mexico has been. As you know, the Director General is a Mexican, and since he assumed the head of IICA, I think he had used his office to proactively provide support to the hemisphere, a lot of people in the hemisphere. For example, on an annual basis, Mexico offers about 100 scholarships for people who are pursuing tertiary education in universities and so forth from degree and postgraduate studies. And in fact, Mexico had also that initiative to where a lot of capacity building courses have been offered 1 week, 2 weeks, a month. Grenada has benefited tremendously, and that has been articulated here by Mr. Charles. And I think he really had a passion in seeing how Mexico, with all its vast resources, but still Mexico has some challenges, as you may well be aware. So it is very admirable to see the kind of support that Mexico has been prepared to provide to countries within the regions, including Grenada. I want to assure the Honorary Council here that Grenada views the support it has received thus far from Mexico highly. And if you have an opportunity to interface with the ambassador, honorable ambassador who is based in St. Lucia, indicate to him how very appreciative Grenada is and continue to be in terms of the support we have received from Mexico.
That you have the tall, you have the hybrids, and you have the dwarfs. So this tall here is an Atlantic or Jamaica tall. Cardi took record of that. This is a Brapan. It is a hybrid between the Brazilian dwarf and the Panama tall. So we understanding it? It's simple. This hybrid will give you a lot of water, it will give you a lot of copper, or a lot of jelly. I don't know if you'll use the jelly. This variety will give you a lot of water. This variety will give you a lot of copper or solid endosperm. Okay? This variety is an ecotype. This variety is an ecotype. That is, they were growing out there in the forest and scientists saw it, they characterized it. They found out about the DNA construct and they domesticated it. So now it's growing with us. Conditions, now we need to discuss this because this is really why we are here, okay? To talk a little more about this technical package. So what I did, in order to present it in a documented way, I use information from what CADI is distributing in the 9 countries and what I've compiled from Mexico. So I try to make it suit our environment as much as possible. So for site selection and layout, this 80 to 100 centimeters in depth is not the depth that you would, your area is supposed to be that depth, 80 to 100 centimeters deep. But that doesn't mean that your palm, let's talk about the plant test we have here, okay Ras, that doesn't mean that your palm will be going that deep. Below there you would have a mixture of sand and coir and some material that so it fills up the hole up to a certain height. So this formulation here, 12 24 12, is what you would need because it's high in phosphorus. You know, phosphorus is needed for root development. Irrigation, I don't know if you still want to talk about irrigation. So during the first year you apply 20 liters of water, and as the plant grows older you will increase. We need to weed around our tissue culture derived plantlets. And what I notice is going on around is that we use the weed whackers or the weed eaters. And we just go and cut all grass. But do you know that not all the grasses can be controlled in that manner? Do you know using the weed eater you propagating more grass? Like the water grass? So certain areas where you have water grass and you have easily controlled grass, you spray, then you weed. So it's an integrated approach.
What causes the coconut water to be kind of carbonated when you drink it? Some of them.
Carbonated is different to carbonated.
Also, it's like a taste. Yes.
I think it has to do with the shelf life of the coconut. And as it grows older, it gets carbonated as a result of some chemical reactions that happens that occur naturally. So the fresher the nut, for example, at the stage, at the developmental stage, you will get the best amount of sugar and quality taste is between 9 to 10 months. It's close, 9 to 10. Between 7 and 8 months old, you have the highest Brix content. So your fruits will be sweeter at that stage. Grenada's coconut industry has the potential to help resuscitate the country's coconut germplasm. Definitely, we know that. With the establishment of these improved planting materials provided by the Mexican government through IICA and the Ministry of Agriculture, Land, Forestry and Fisheries, Grenada. This here is very important. This here would help us to regulate the price of the plantlets. This here would help us to, these coconut specific policies at the high level would put us at a position to promote our protocols and force people to adhere to it, because it's very important. So we have work to do. For example, if your plantlets, you can introduce experts to do evaluation resistance and agronomy, and we need increased areas in coconuts. Apart from myself, who do a little work, we have others like Eden Compton. I think he did some consultancy work in the Caribbean. And he's willing, I think, because the last time I contacted him, it's like he wants to come back in the Caribbean.
He's from?
Pardon? He's from the UK.
The UK.
Land Mills Company, I think. This is Dr. Misselin. Dr. Wall is from, I should be her, from Jamaica. This is Wayne Myrie. Sorry about the contrast. It's from Jamaica. This is Carlos Oropesa, Dr. Florent Angelman, and this is another researcher from Africa, all dedicated to doing work, especially in botany and pathology. But we need more expertise, you know, in order to help us in the Caribbean. We don't have to depend on them. We can have our own expertise now in our countries to help us develop our coconut industry on the whole. So in saying that, I'd like to say thank you to IICA. It wasn't possible, if it wasn't for them, it would not be possible for me to be here to talk to you and have this little discussion. And my ministry and also Ministry of Grenada for being here and making this workshop of substance. Even if they're not here right now, but this center in Mexico, Centro de Investigación Científica de Yucatán, for helping to build capacity and making it possible so that we get this plant that's here in the day. So I'd like to say thank you all. Once again, thank you.